K.C. Keeler, you guys allowed 400 yards in the second half. What happened after intermission?
Well, a couple things. First of all, you know, you can't drop a touchdown pass going into halftime. Then you miss a field goal. I mean, just too big a momentum shift. And then second half, they came out and started going some up-tempo things. We thought that they were changing some personnel and we should have had the time to substitute. And the officials didn't see it that way, so we'll get the film to figure that out. So it kind of put us off guard a little bit. We got caught kind of trying to get different personnel on and off the field, but they did a good job. They executed. We didn't execute. They made some plays. We didn't make some plays. You know, there's some blitzes they got us on that we should have been able to handle, and that's disappointing because these are things we anticipated and we walked through and the kids saw it in practice, and then we don't make the play, you know. So and those are huge when you're got decent field position and you can, you know, pick up a first down or possibly a touchdown instead of getting a sack. I mean, those are the kind of plays that really hurt us. So both sides of the ball really struggled in the second half. I thought the first half we could have been up 21-0. And that would have been obviously, you know, big momentum shift going into halftime, but us missing the field goal and us dropping the touchdown pass, I think definitely, you know, gave them some hope, saying, you know what, we didn't play well, but we're right in this thing. And they came out and we had a three and out, which we couldn't do, got a poor punt. So it was all phases, and they go down and score, and all of a sudden they're getting some momentum going, and boy, they took it to us after that.
Yeah, momentum, a key word. It's a young football team you have, and after four and a half games, didn't have a single deficit all year long. How much of it was it kind of just snowballing on a young team having to go through this once?
Well, you know, I think part of it's making plays, you know, but there is a sense of, you know, it's your first time you're down, and, you know, how are you going to react? And we didn't react well. Be interested to see the film, you know, why some of the things that they made some plays, you know, that was part of it. They did make some plays, and it's a potent offense. I mean, they do a really good job, and the quarterback made some plays that you know, sometimes you can't defend. But again, it all goes back to that first half. We had all the opportunities in the world the first half. We didn't take care of that. You know, gave them an opportunity to get back in this thing. They got back in it in a big way, and we couldn't slow them down.
Trent, with the interceptions in the second half, he had done such a good job of taking care of the football since the opener against Westchester. Was that just pressing there at the end, or was that something you saw?
Well, you know, I think he got a little frustrated, and I think a couple were bad balls. And then the first one definitely was, you know, he should have been reading the corner instead of looking at the receiver. And if he reads the corner, he sees the corner's in position, he's not going to go there. So, you know, that's the one thing with a young quarterback sometimes is that sometimes they you know, got off their reads and try to make a play. And when he got off his read and tried to make a play, the play wasn't there. So, again, you know, I think there's some things are very correctable. As I told the kids, I said, you know, if we continue to play like this, we won't win another ball game in this league. You know, first 4 weeks, you have to like the progress we've made. And even Sean said to me prior to the game, boy, you guys have really improved the first 4 weeks of the season. Really took a step backwards today, and it's going to be really interesting to see how this team responds.
Well, we're looking forward to see it. Thanks so much for your time, Coach.
Thanks, guys.
Zach Kerr, what happened defensively in that second half? You guys dominated the line of scrimmage in the first half and then just couldn't get off the field second half.
Honestly, I just got to take my hat off to, you know, New Hampshire. It's a great offensive football team. They got a great scheme they run, and I'd be crazy to say, you know, the 11 guys, you know, on defense in the second half didn't fight to the end. It is, you know, they just, New Hampshire just played a hell of a football game, and, you know, I just got to take my hat off to those guys.
When you go through the first four and a half games, don't have a single deficit, everything seems to be going so well, and then it changes suddenly the way it did here this afternoon. How hard was it for you guys to react?
Actually, it wasn't hard at all. You would have thought we were winning on the sideline when we were down. And, you know, that's the beauty of the game of football is that it's four quarters. And regardless of what everybody else thought, we still thought we were going to win the game. And, I mean, that's just, you know, that's the approach we took. Second half, first quarter, third quarter, second quarter, fourth quarter, you know. So, I mean, that's just it was a good football game played by New Hampshire, and I really give all the credit to them. It's nothing that we did wrong or nothing that we did, you know, that was out of the ordinary. They just played a great football game today.
What was the message from the coaching staff in the locker room after the game?
Remember what this felt like. And, you know, basically we got to prepare better next week and just come out and play. You know, and I trust every, you know, coach on this coaching staff. They coach his heart. You know, every week, every day, they coach us hard. So, I mean, I'm just ready to get back to it. I'm ready to get back on this plane and get back to Delaware and get back to work.
Well, Zach, have a safe flight back. We appreciate you coming out and talking to us.
I appreciate it. Thank you.